Billionaire Charlie back at it again, man, with the hot topic for the day, man. Hit that like, hit that subscribe button for me. And if you'd like to donate to the channel, my Cash App information right there below. But once again, we got a hot one today, man. We just found out breaking news about the Nipsey Hussle situation, man. Shot 6 times, you know what I mean? Pronounced dead on the scene at his clothing store. You know what I'm saying? It's a sad thing to see something like that, man. And it just goes back to one of the Vlad interviews that I just seen. You know what I'm saying? Not seen, but seen before. When Boosie was talking about continuously staying in those neighborhoods that you grew up from and just experience different hate from people around, man. Everybody is not excited about your success. One of my pastors was preaching about that today. You know what I'm saying? Just talking about when you going back into those type of environments and things of that nature, and instead of moving forward into your progress, you will begin to see all these people around you, the crab in the bucket type of mentality. You know what I'm saying? But there's a lot of theories out there right now and already. You know what I mean? Some people trying to accuse the baby mamas and things of that nature. And they also believing that the Dr. Sebi documentary had some influence on it. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people didn't believe that he was equipped to be putting that type of information out there, or to keep Dr. Sebi's legacy alive by bringing out the documentary. So like I say, man, people got their own theories of what the situation was all about, you know what I'm saying? And some people believe it was a Dr. Sebi situation, because it was multiple wives that was involved with Dr. Sebi getting to the level that he was at, far as all the medical things that he was able to heal, not cure, but heal. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people didn't believe that the right wife was the one that needed to be in the documentary. So a lot of people got a lot of theories on what happened with the situation. Right now, everybody, they still trying to do the investigation and find out and get some more clarity into the situation. Yes, he was shot 6 times, you know what I'm saying, right in front of this store. And it's is a sad thing, because in our communities, you know what I mean, we always talking Black Lives Matter and things of that nature, but yet we keep taking each other lives and don't care about it, you know what I'm saying? His family, his kids is all going to miss him, you know what I'm saying? And all the great things he done for all the years that he was around, you know what I'm saying? So sometimes we got to realize, man, it's not worth going around doing things like this, man. And gun violence in our community is getting out of hand, and we definitely need changes out here. You know what I'm saying? So, like, when I seen the news, man, I couldn't believe what I was just looking at, man. A legend, definitely going to be a legend in the rap game. He was always on the independent circuit with his music and things of that nature. One of the first people that put out an album that was worth $100, man. See, I know the history of Nipsey Hussle and all the things that he was doing, you know what I'm saying, and all the grinds he was on, clothing line and things of that nature. Just branching out and just being an entrepreneur. He was a person that had a vision, you know what I'm saying? And like Boosie was saying, man, when you go back to those neighborhoods where you grew up from and being around and the surroundings, and there's so many people that have hate in their heart for you because you move past them. You're not on their level anymore. You're on a different level, different path, and you have to protect yourself by putting yourself in a better situation. You know what I'm saying? Moving alone and sometimes being out there, you know what I'm saying, can get you caught up real quick. And this situation is very sad. My condolences to the family and everybody that's dealing with this situation, man. My prayers out there for all of them that's have to go through this situation. And I just pray that they be able to get through it. I know it's a tough and rough situation, and we definitely got to stop gun violence in our communities and just put prayer out that we can see changes start to develop, man, because we all know that he was a Crip, and we all know his blood situations. But it could have not been Crip or blood affiliate. It could have been about the documentary. It could have been a love situation. You know what I'm saying? We never know, man. But like I say, don't just try to throw it on some game thing. Let's get the truth. You know what I'm saying? Or the reason why this happened. You know what I mean? But definitely, man, it's a painful thing to seeing somebody get gunned down that was doing positive things in his community for his family. You know what I'm saying? And for his career, from a person that was in the streets and all they knew was the streets, to be able to get from that and become, you know what I'm saying, independent on your own and making your own foundations and money and things of that nature is a big thing, man. change, man. We need change in our communities. But this billionaire Charlie, man, love all of y'all out there. Hit that like, hit that subscribe button for me. You know what I mean? And we're gonna keep breaking the news on this. And the more I get more information, I'm gonna release it to you, all right? Love y'all, man. Put God first, family and finances.